We have learnt about spatial understanding. We have taught the children the basic concepts. Now, objects. Identifying objects. How to identify objects? Children would have done it already. First and second graders know object identification. Even then, we give them more training. We explain about different characteristics of objects. This way, based on the characteristics of the objects, we make them segregate the objects. Children will do it happily. It is like a game for them. They keep playing the games and understand the concepts clearly. Let us see how. Now, I will take these many DLMs and I'll keep them together here. Okay, then I'll ask the children, what is this? This is the square counter, right? What is this? Abacus ring. Children should be allowed to touch. Then they understand this is different. The characteristics of this and this are different. They will understand. This is a yellow cube. This is different. Now, I will give them this and ask them to segregate based on shapes. Which one looks like this, feels like this? It has the same shape. They are of the same size. Keep them aside based on this shape and size. Now, these square counters, let us keep them all on this side. Yeah? And now, all these yellow cubes. Let us keep them all in a group down here. Some kids are very systematic. They will separate these first and only then separate the others. But some kids, they just pick whichever and start segregating them. We should not force them to do it only in this particular way. Totally, they should learn how to segregate them based on the characteristics and group them. Let them take their own time. Let them look at them. This is yellow. This is red. I will pick blue first. I'll take the blue ones and keep them. This way, they will keep talking happily and segregate them. Let them do it. Encourage them. Tell them, very good. Similarly, like this, we can make them do a lot of activities. In the morning, during the assembly time, we can ask them to pick flowers, small stones, pebbles, not to get hurt. All these they can pick and put them together and segregate them. Jackfruit seeds, tamarind seeds, such seeds can be put in a box and all these can be used to segregate in the class. Keep all the leaves on one side, all the seeds on the other side. This can be done. Now, what have we done? We have segregated the objects based on shape. Now, the same activity can be done in a different way. We know the colors of these, right? Based on the colors of these objects, let us segregate. Which color is this? This is green. Which color is this? This is red. This one is yellow. Do we have any other color? No, we have only these many. This green is different from this green slightly. But we will take them as green. Okay? This red and this red are different. But we will take it as red. We will segregate them based on their colors. Where shall we start? Tell me which color. Yellow is more, right? Let us pick the yellow ones first. Red we'll keep on this side. Let's take the green ones and group them here. What else do we have? The blue ones. Let's keep the blue ones here. Like this. We have segregated based on color. Look at it, so beautiful. All the colors were together. We have separated them and kept. What did we do? We separated them based on color. We segregated them. For children, The words segregation and separation are big ones. These are for teachers' understanding. But we can say separate them, keep them separately. Then it becomes simple. This way, this activity, we can make them do using different objects. Bangles. Children will be using colorful bangles. We can ask them to segregate based on color and make them play. After this, comparison. Comparing objects based on shape. Comparing shapes. Not measuring the objects. Children have not reached the measuring stage, but based on size, by looking at them, they should understand this is big, this is small, this is tall, this is short. This way, they must understand the concepts. Let us do some activities for this. This is yellow. This is white. We have green and blue. Are all these the same size? Are they all big or are they all small? They are different. This is the biggest of them all, isn't it? Now, if we take these two, which is big and which is small? This is big. This is small. We have seen this already. If we take this, which is small? Yellow is smaller than blue. These two are smaller than blue. Isn't it? If we take this is small and this is very small, tiny. Which is biggest of them all? Will you tell? This, isn't it? This is the biggest of them all. Which is the smallest? This one? No. There is a smaller one, tiny. Which is smaller between these two? Both are same size, right? So any one is okay. We will keep one aside. This one is enough. This is the smallest and this is the biggest. This way, we can teach them comparison by just looking at them. This activity, we can take the pencil boxes that they have or the erasers that they have, books that they have. We can take the children of one bench into a group, keep the objects close by and teach them how to compare based on the shapes. We can teach through activities.